So hello and welcome guys, this is Ashutosh, your host, and I welcome you all in this new video tutorial segment of Concept of the Day. So guys, what you are seeing over here, this is called power system, okay? An electric power system, guys, consists of three principal components. आप यहां पर देख सकते हैं, एक इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर सिस्टम को तीन भागों में डिवाइड किया जाता है. एंड दे आर, फर्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड जनरेटिंग सिस्टम, सेकेंड वन इज ट्रांसमिशन सिस्टम, एंड थर्ड वन इज कॉल्ड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम. सो गाइस, दीज आर द कंपोनेंट्स, दीज आर द मेन कंपोनेंट, प्रिंसिपल कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर सिस्टम. सो गाइस, हियर यू कैन सी the power system. What is power system? Okay, what is a power system? The question arises. So you can see over here, the power system is a network which consists generation, distribution and transmission system. So guys, it uses the form of energy like coal and diesel and converts it into electrical energy. And the power system includes the devices connected to the system like synchronous generators, motors, transformers, circuit breakers, conductors, etc. So here you can also see guys, electric system, these are the electric system components. Okay, where generation is there, the first part is generation, then transmission network, second part, then substations, distribution network is there, substations and transformers are there, and then homes, okay, utilization. Okay, the fourth category is utilization, where electrical power is or electrical energy is utilized, okay, in these homes by the consumers, okay, in homes and in various industries. Okay, so guys, at generating plant, what happens? You can see over here, at generating plant, electric power is stepped up to several thousand volts by a transformer and delivered to the transmission line. As you can see over here, this is the power plant. You can see in the diagram, actually this is the generating power station where voltage is generated, okay, at 11,000 volt Indian standard rating, okay, and 50 hertz frequency. So you can see over here, and then it is stepped up. This is the power transformer. You can see over here in the diagram, okay, this is power transformer, and the voltage is stepped up to, okay, from 11 kV up to several different levels of voltages, transmission voltages. Okay, we already discussed the different levels of transmission voltages are available in India are from 132 kV, okay, 66 kV, 132 kV, okay, 220 kilovolt, then 400 kV, and latest 765 kilovolt. And then, okay, so guys, after at numerous substations, you can also see the second sentence. At numerous substations on the transmission system, transformers step down the power to a lower voltage and deliver it to distribution lines, and then distribution lines carry power to homes. So guys, basically we were at number one point, power station, okay, at power stations. So after electrical power is generated, it is transmitted over the long distances using transmission line, as you can see over here. Okay, after this generation part comes transmission network, transmission system network. Okay, so this part, okay, started from here. This is called transmission system, where what happens, transmission lines are constructed between transmission substations, okay, located at electric generating stations. And guys, these are the steel towers on which these transmission lines are supported on. okay, and they may be overhead, there may be overhead transmission, or there could be underground transmission also. So they are operated at high voltages and they send out large amount of electrical power and extend over considerable distances. So guys, when electricity comes out of a generating station, the transmission substation located there steps up the voltage to the different ranges. And then guys, you can see over here, this is the transmission substation, okay, and then this is the receiving end, and then after receiving reception of this large amount of power at high voltages, okay, then the voltage will be stepped down. You can see over here at numerous substations on the transmission system, transformers step down the power to a lower voltage and deliver it to distribution lines. So guys, then voltage is stepped down and then it is delivered to the distribution lines, and then distribution network started, okay, starts. So distribution networks, so you can see on the diagram, this is the distribution system, okay, distribution substation are situated over here. And then two types of distributions are important. First is called primary distributions. Okay, you can see over here, this is the primary distribution where power is sent to the commercial and industrial business consumers. Okay, this is called the commercial, means industries, various plants, okay, come under this category. And then secondary distribution, okay, where 11 kilovolt is stepped down up to 230 volt single phase, okay, and 440 volt line to line voltage. Okay, so this is called secondary distribution, and power is then distributed, okay, to the various homes. Okay, so this is called secondary distribution. So you can read the sentence, distribution lines carry power to farms, homes and businesses. So guys, these are the different electrical system components. So guys, here you can see over here on your screen, this is called AC electric power supply system, or also called single line diagram. You can see on the left side, okay, this is the first of all, this is the power station, okay, the symbol shows of power station, okay, and alternating current, alternating power is generated over here, and voltage induced at 11 kilovolt, okay, power is generated at 11 kilovolt Indian, according to Indian standard rating, and 50 hertz frequency is there. And guys, then comes, okay, then there will be a power transformer at generating substation. So this is a power transformer, you can see over here, and where 11 kilovolt, okay, voltage is stepped up to various ranges of transmission voltages. Like here, it is shown over here 220 kV. At the right side also you can see, okay, this is step up transformer. Aap yahan par dekh sakte hain, 11 kilovolt is Indian standard, okay, generating voltage, and generating frequency is 50 hertz. You can see, so this is generating station, okay, and then this is the symbol of power transformer, step up transformer, where voltage is stepped up to 220 kV according to this picture, okay. And then guys, transmission system starts, where we already discussed there are transmission lines, okay, at high voltages they carry electrical power, large electrical power at high voltages, okay, okay, and they are supported on the steel towers, okay, and they transmit the electric power over long distances. So this is called primary transmission, okay, and it operates at high voltages. So here also you can see the transmissions after generation part, the transmission part starts, okay. So this is called primary transmission, and this is also called primary transmission. Okay, so this part is called primary transmission. And then guys, at receiving end, okay, well, this is the receiving end. You can see over here, this is the receiving end. So where at receiving end, at the right side, you can see there will be installed a step down transformer. We already discussed in our previous slide. So there are numerous, okay, power substations, okay, substation, receiving substations, okay, at a transmission system where power is or voltage is stepped down to lower voltages. Like here in the slide, you can see over here, step down transformer is utilized over here, and 220 kilo voltage is stepped down up to 33 kV. And then guys, secondary transmission starts after this. This is called secondary transmission. Secondary transmission. Okay. Also, after step down this voltage, okay, up to 33 kV, we can supply it to the various industrial consumers also. Okay. So, and what happens, guys? Then at substations, you can see in the picture, and then distribution starts actually. Okay. After here you can see over here, okay, these are the distribution system. Okay, you can see over here, this is called the distribution system. Okay, this comprises of primary distribution and secondary distribution. Okay, you can see over here also, primary distribution and secondary distribution. So what happens here, you can see over here, at receiving end substation, okay, at primary distribution, the voltage is again stepped down, okay, from 33 kV up to 6.6 kV, or 11 kilovolt, and primary, it is supplied to primary consumers like businesses, industrial consumers, commercial industrial consumers, okay, and big industries, okay, so to large bulk loads like factories, industries, you can see over here. So this is called primary distribution. Okay, this is called primary distribution. Yahan par bhi aap dekh sakte hain. Aur uske baad guys, 11 kilovolt ko, और या 6.6 kV, बेसिकली 11 किलो वोल्ट इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड जो है वो, उस वोल्टेज को अगेन वी स्टेप डाउन अप टू 230 वोल्ट सिंगल फेज वोल्टेज, और 400 और 440 वोल्ट लाइन टू लाइन वोल्टेज. एंड देन गाइस, व्हाट हैपेंस, यू कैन सी ओवर हियर, देन सेकेंडरी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन स्टार्ट्स, वेयर ओके, आप इतना वोल्ट जो हाई वोल्टेज होता है 11 किलो वोल्ट को, उसको आपने स्टेप डाउन किया है 230 वोल्ट सिंगल फेज में. और गाइस, यहां से आप इसको सर्विसमेंस और डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स की सहायता से, ओके, ये डिफरेंट आप होम्स को सप्लाई करते हैं. ओके, देन यू सेंड दीज इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर, ओके, टू द कंज्यूमर्स, ओके, ऑफ इन वेरियस होम्स. ओके, एंड यू कैन सी ओवर हियर. Okay, so here by using service mains, this is a small cable, okay, which connects the distributor to the consumer. This is the link. Okay, aap yahan par dekh sakte hain guys. So this is called basically an electric power supply system, and then power is finally utilized by these consumers. Okay, so guys, basically you can see on the screen, so basically in all power plants, electromagnetic induction principle of Faraday's law, which you know, okay, the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction principle is used for the electric power generation. Aap yahan par dekh sakte hain guys, okay, this is the picture of, okay, generator, where you can see over here, this is the, okay, generator picture. So what principle is used, we already discussed, okay, in our previous classes, Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, and you must have studied this law in your 12th class, okay, in schools. So guys, what happens, okay, if a wire is, so this is basically, it consists of magnets, okay, this is called magnet. North pole is there, south pole is there, and there will be magnetic field. You see, okay, from it is directed from north towards south. So there will be magnetic field like this, okay. Flux lines will be there, okay. Uniform magnetic field will be there between these poles. And what happens here also, you can see these are the poles, electromagnetic poles. And what happens, guys, if a wire, you can see, read the sentence, if a wire is moved across a magnetic field at right angles, a voltage is induced in the wire. So if a wire, these are the rectangular wires or coils, you can see these are the rectangular coils, okay, situated between, these are placed between the uniform magnetic field. So guys, basically if a wire is moved across a magnetic field at right angles or at any angles, a voltage is induced in the wire. So what is the principle of electromagnetic induction? So according to Faraday's law, you know, EMF induced is directly proportional to d phi by dt. So it says whenever there is a change in magnetic flux, there will be in a coil, okay, there will be, or in a conductor, there will be induced EMF in it, okay, in that conductor. So if wire is a part of circuit, then current will flow, you see. And if the wire is moved in the opposite direction, the induced voltage or current will be in the opposite direction. And to increase the size of the voltage or current, then the we have to increase the use of stronger magnet and move the wire more quickly. And the, if the wire is held stationary or moved parallel, okay, at 0 degree, so no voltage will be induced. So you also, so guys, you can see, okay, at power stations, first sentence you can read, an installation where electric power is generated for distribution. So this is the place, powers, these are called power stations or generating stations, okay. So it is also referred, you can see, also referred to as a power plant. And sometimes generating station or generating plant is an industrial facility for the generation of electrical power. And power stations are generally connected to an electrical grid, and many power stations contain one or more generators, a rotating machine that converts mechanical power into three-phase electrical power. And the relative motion between a magnetic field and a conductor creates an electric current. So we already discussed the principle of generation of electrical power, that is called Faraday's electromagnetic induction. And guys, here you can see there are two types of power plants are there. Basically, these are divided into two categories. First, you see conventional sources of energy. So these are hydroelectric power stations, thermal power stations, diesel power stations, and nuclear power stations. So these are, okay, these are called conventional sources of energy. And second type is called non-conventional sources of energy, where solar power, okay, wind power, tidal power, MSD, geothermal power, and fuel cells come in these categories. So these are non-conventional sources of energy. So what happens, guys, basically bulk electric power is produced by special plant is known as a generating station. And generating station essentially employs a prime mover coupled to an alternator for the production of electric power, and the alternator converts mechanical energy of the prime mover into electrical energy. And the electrical energy produced by the generating station is transmitted and distributed with the help of conductors of various consumer. So guys, we already discussed in our slides. So these are also types of generating stations. These are conventional types. Okay, steam power plant, that is called thermal power plant, hydroelectric, diesel power plant, nuclear power plant. And guys, here you can see the transmission system. Okay, so basically transmission lines are sets of wires called conductors that carry electrical power from generating plants to the substations that deliver power to customers. and at a generating plant, electric power is stepped up to several thousand volts by a transformer and delivered to the transmission line. And at numerous substations on the transmission system, transformers step down the power to a lower voltage and deliver it to distribution line, which we already discussed, guys, in our previous slides. And distribution lines carry power to farms, homes, and businesses. And the type of transmission structures used for any project is determined by the characteristics of the transmission line's route, including terrain and existing infrastructure. So basically, guys, there are two types of transmission available in India: overhead transmission, okay, and it is used mostly. So guys, here is the diagram of a transmission line, okay, that is supported on the steel tower, as you can see over here. So guys, basically you can see these are the steel towers, okay, on which these transmission lines are carried, okay, and these are the steel towers, as you can see on the right side. Also at left side you can see, so this is typical transmission line structure. So this is called tower, as you can see over here. This is called tower, and these are the suspension insulators, okay, you can see over here. These are called insulators, okay, disc insulators. These are actually strings of disc insulators, okay, and these are called suspension insulators. And this is the conductor. You see, these are the transmission line, okay, basically it is called ACSR conductors, aluminium conductor, steel reinforced, okay. So these are ACSR conductors, okay, and these are cross arms, you can see over here. These are cross arms, and okay, and the top conductor, you can see over here, this is the top conductor, okay, that run, okay, on the steel tower, okay. This is called earth wire, which protects these transmission line from large amount of surges, okay, during lightning.